Hey guys, how's it going? Like Butter here, and today I got a Fortnite video. We're gonna be doing something a little bit different than the normal BR stuff. We're gonna be talking about Save the World a little bit today because there is another sale on Save the World, which is 50% off. Now, apparently, Save the World is eventually going to be free like the Battle Royale. However, considering that I don't even think Save the World's like half done, Canny Valley and I forget what the other one's called. We can see it here. It's really unfinished, so I don't think that Save the World's going to be 100% finished and ready to be considered a, you know, full game this year. I think they're actually going to delay it a little bit because they've been working a lot on the new stuff, like trying to add these weekly events and whatnot. However, since they are shutting Paragon down, that team might be coming over to work on Save the World, so I have no idea. But I think this is a pretty good deal, and I'm going to explain why. First of all, we all know that Battle Royale has some of the best cosmetics that I've seen in any game. And you're probably here because you're trying to figure out whether you want to spend money on V-Bucks or you want to buy the PvE so that you can progressively spawn V-Bucks every single day. I always, I always farm V-Bucks every day. I get on, I do my daily, and I get about 50 V-Bucks every single day just for doing the daily missions. Then on top of that, they have special events where you can do these like small missions and progress, and then all of a sudden you're getting like 100, maybe even 200 V-Bucks. Also, all your defense missions, your shield defense missions, you're going to get V-Bucks as well. And sometimes they'll even have it in the shop where you can purchase the V-Bucks with, you know, the seasonal gold. So let's talk about that. So this is 50% off. It's a pretty good deal. Now, I would recommend buying the $150 version, which is going to end up being about like $70 or something like that, $75. The reason being because they give you these daily login bonuses. Like, I just got 150 V-Bucks for signing in today because it just gives you these daily sign-ins. And then, so we're going to open up these llamas. This is how you're going to progress through the PvE. You get like, you know, you get these cards, and then because you get these cards, you end up getting a bunch of stuff, and it's good. Also, when you are here, I'm going to show you guys here. When you're first starting out, you're going to get a lot of llamas if you buy like the higher unlimited edition, I think it's called. You're going to get higher stuff. I think actually, now that I think about it, there's like a $150 version, and there's like a $300 version. The $150 version is going to go down quite a bit in price since it's, you know, it's 50% off. I can't remember the exact prices. I ended up spending the $150. I think I got the highest one that you could possibly get. And then I actually upgraded it after that, which was an additional $100 at the time. And that ended up, you know, making a lot of sense in the long run because I ended up being able to farm a lot more V-Bucks because I was getting tons of llamas, which gave me tons of duplicates, which I could put in my collection book. And if you go in your collection book, you can put things in here. So for example, I could put my dragon spear in here. I'm not going to use this. So you can permanently slot it and it'll level you up. And if I'm not mistaken, earlier on in the levels, you get V-Bucks, you get llamas, you get a bunch of stuff that can help you level up and progress through your campaign. And when you progress through your campaign, you're gonna have more stuff to do to get V-Bucks. Now, if you are primarily a Battle Royale player like myself, I just play the PvE to farm the V-Bucks. That's all I do. It's pretty fun. It's a cool thing. It's kind of like a mindless thing to do while you're watching other streams or whatnot. But it's nice because I think I've earned either between 7 to 8,000 V-Bucks, which is around like $70 to $80 in value, just by playing, you know, through the game. And since I own the PvE, I'm gonna be able to, you know, continually farm it as we go. Another thing you want to keep in consideration is that if you do buy one of the higher versions of the game, you're going to get free codes to give to a couple of your friends. So maybe a couple of your friends that you play Battle Royale with, you know, they don't own the PvE and they want to farm some V-Bucks too. You guys can do that. So first things first, you want to check your daily quests every day. You're going to get V-Bucks from your daily quests. I always do these. They're usually pretty easy. And if it's something that you don't like, you can always abandon the quest and it will re-roll for another one. So this is Discover Outdoor Survivor Shelters. I actually hate this one. It's so annoying. And then you go through, you do your quests, and you'll get 50 V-Bucks every day. And that V-Bucks does transfer over to the BR. I don't spend any V-Bucks on PvE, because if you do get one of the higher versions, you're going to earn enough llamas and other things just from daily logins and from the XP boosts that it gives you, that you're going to be good on llamas. You don't need to spend the V-Bucks on llamas. So you can just continue to spend all the V-Bucks on skins and BR like I do. And then here in the events, there's going to be like Spring and On. And I believe there was another event that just passed, a Valentine's event. Now, when you play through these missions, it's going to give you opportunities to unlock V-Bucks. So say maybe after I finish this mission here, it'll give me a mission to unlock V-Bucks. That's just an example. That's not how it is. I already did them. But then you're going to earn V-Bucks through this, and you're going to earn V-Bucks through your dailies. You're going to earn V-Bucks through your main quests when you go through shield defense missions and all that other stuff. So you're going to start stacking V-Bucks extremely fast. And if you save them all for BR, you're going to get like, I think, 3 to 4, maybe like 600 to 800 V-Bucks skins for free every other week. And that it hit a certain point where I didn't have to spend any money. I actually put $100 into the BR, but that was just because I was getting low on V-Bucks because I stopped farming the PvE for a bit. Now, if I continued to farm, I probably would have had unlimited V-Bucks. So, so like pretty much what I'll do here is I got my daily, I got my sign-in, you know, my sign-in reward. And I'm just going to go in here and I'm going to go to one of the missions that doesn't really matter because my quest, you can go anywhere. But like if you want to do fire, like the fire truck, you got to destroy like 3 fire trucks. You might want to go to like a suburban area where there's going to be like little fire stations and whatnot. And then it'll tell you most of the zones you want to go to. But this one that I have now can be in any zone. So I usually go to one of the really low missions to just make it a little bit easier. So I'll just go here, select it, and then we'll go in and we'll just do one of the missions. So the PvE, a lot of people ask, is the PvE worth it? Is it worth the time? And a lot of people say that it's not worth it because the V-Bucks come very slow. But they're not taking into consideration that you do earn a lot of V-Bucks throughout the beginning of the game when you're going through your shield defense missions. And it's the game basically tries rewarding you V-Bucks in the beginning to get you to buy some of the llamas, to kind of get you going a little bit and give you like that good feeling of getting the llamas. It's just all like a business tactic, really. And then eventually you can spend real money on the llamas if you would like, or you can just play the game. I've never spent a dime on, PvE llamas. Like I said, I save all my V-Bucks for the Battle Royale. So we're just going to go into a mission here, and I'm going to show you guys just kind of what the PvE is like, just very briefly. And you're also going to have this overhead on your map that's going to show you where your missions are. You know, you may have a mission where you got to destroy, I don't know, for example, 3 cop cars. And then you go and destroy those, and it will give you those V-Bucks that you can use in BR. Also, I've seen a lot where you gotta destroy these seesaws. I didn't see any there, but I think there's a big there's a big thing over here. We can just destroy a bunch of seesaws, and this game's kind of like it reminds me of like Plants vs Zombies with a mixture of like Borderlands, kind of. It's really strange. It's like hard to explain, but it's pretty fun. It can be boring at times, but I think if you're farming it for the V-Bucks, it's definitely worth it. So let's go over here, and we're in this. See, here are the seesaws here. We could just destroy those if we had a mission, and it would give us V-Bucks for it. You can always look up, I'm sure there's tutorials online on, like, you know, how to get certain things. Maybe you want to figure out the easiest way to discover city locations or something like that. I'm sure there's videos that show that. I'm not going to do that because I actually just go through and do it myself, and that would take forever. But here's, I think this is one of the little shelters I need to see. Actually, I don't think it is. Oh, it is. Okay. Survivor shelter. That's what I need to find. And you can see it on the right. And you can also go through to your quests here, and you can pin your quests so that you can see in the right hand corner what quests you have to do. And it's all pretty like brainless, you know, like if you're usually playing with other players, and it's pretty easy to just get through the stuff. Obviously, I'm way over leveled for this mission, so I'm just one hitting everything. But it's pretty cool. It's really in depth. I don't think the game really explains like the tree, like the skill tree system and all the complexity of the PvE very well. But you'll learn as you go, and there's people that will help you. Like the Fortnite PvE community is pretty non-toxic for the most part. You're always going to get one or two bad apples, but for the most part, people are there to help you out since it is PvE and everyone's kind of there on the same side. And you can go through and you get ammo and you just farm materials, and eventually you'll have to do the mission, which is the big, you know, exclamation point over there. We'll go over there, we'll build, and when we finish the mission, you get a scoring, and that scoring will give you, you know, certain loot at the end of the match. So I'm just going through and I'm just looking for these survivor shelters. Since everyone is kind of, when everyone spawns in at first, everyone kind of just runs around and does their own thing. Because everyone's, you know, working on missions and whatnot. So I would just run around here. I would find my survivor shelters, which I always have a problem doing because they're random as far as I know. But I'm looking for the little shelters that the survivors stand in, and sometimes they're not there. And yeah, so if you have also, if you need to destroy a certain amount of things, they'll most likely come up on your overhead map as an exclamation point, and you can go over there. Also, other players can do the same thing for you, by the way. They can also hit certain stuff. There's another one there. They can hit things for you. So say you need to destroy a certain amount of TVs, and so you're near somebody, and you can see that they're next to the TVs, and there's a bunch of exclamation points on the map. You can have them hit it for you, and I'd say like 95% of the time people will do it for you. If you ask them in chat, so. But anyways, yeah, I just wanted to make this video to kind of give you guys a little tutorial on how to get V-Bucks in PvE. It's pretty easy once you get the hang of it. It's, like I said, there's three main ways. Main quests, the event that's going on, and then your dailies. And that's going to stack up. You're going to see yourself getting a lot of V-Bucks. And I even think in the beginning of the game, it starts you off with like 500 or so. Because they give you like 500 for a certain mission. So I'd say about an hour into the campaign, you're going to have like 1,000 or 2,000 V-Bucks already just from playing the game. And then, you know, your daily logins, sometimes it'll give you V-Bucks and whatnot. And it's because they're trying to give the PvE players V-Bucks so that they can progress through the game and buy the llamas. But since it transfers over to BR, you can just do what I do and just use it for BR. But anyways, guys, just wanted to make this video. Hopefully you enjoyed. If you did, be sure to drop the video a like. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. If I've had a couple people come and say that they bought the PvE during the last sale, and they're happy that they did because they've been constantly farming V-Bucks for the Battle Royale. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll talk to you next time. Take care, everybody.